All right, welcome back to Computer Vision. Today we're gonna do just a little bit on video. Today, and I guess next one will be our, we're only gonna talk two of these lessons on video. One could do almost an entire class on computer vision as applied to video and the things that are different, but we're not gonna do a lot of that. A lot of what you've learned can be applied obviously to each of the individual images, and some of what you've learned where they're essentially two-dimensional operators, you can apply those same operators in three dimensions or other ways of thinking about video, but we're only gonna do a little. In fact, talking about the three dimensions, video we're gonna think of as a three-dimensional signal, right? So video, as shown here, is I have this image XY, and as time moves forward, time could also go that way, the idea is that I've got this volume of data. And so a pixel inside a video is actually a function of X, Y, and T, right? So sometimes you'll see me going like this for video, and I'm talking about X, Y, and T. You know, that's the way I think of video, is I think of video as a volume of data. So let's talk a little bit about some basic computer vision in video. So one might be object detection. So suppose your goal, and we'll talk a little bit about this next time, is activity recognition, right? You want to recognize what's going on. So you're going to recognize the activity of objects, of people, et cetera, but there are these entities doing something. So you might have to find these entities. That is, what are the things in here that are moving, that are doing something, that I need to try to label what their activity is? You know, nominally or notionally, you can think of as my goal is to find the independently moving things that are in this video. So here I've labeled this thing called background subtraction, and it's, you know, just an example. I mean, here we have a scene where there's some cars moving, and the idea would be, well, you know, we'd like to be able to find all of these moving blobs, right? In this particular case, all these moving blobs are the moving objects. Generically, background subtraction is used a lot. It used to be that people thought that background subtraction was trivial, and then they thought it was hard, and then they stopped thinking about it at all. It's still, this notion of separating out the entities is still a fundamental research area in computer vision. We're going to talk about some simple stuff here. So the most straightforward background subtraction is where you have a static camera. So the camera is not moving, and the idea being that if nothing is changing in the scene, then nothing is moving there either, and there's nothing to do, so you should go home and get some rest. All right? Background subtraction, as sort of simple and overly simplistic as it is used a lot in commercial systems, traffic monitoring, where they're you know, counting cars or monitoring other things going on, various human action recognition, where you have people coming by and you want to be able to say something about walking, running, whatever. Human-computer interaction, so people will build systems where humans interact with a big display, and to pull the humans out from the background, they have to remove the background somehow, and sort of object tracking in general. So sometimes there what you'll do is you'll compensate for the motion of the camera, so you'll move the whole image back as if you had the camera stationary, and then you do background subtraction on that.